Hey guys, Alex J here. So, the eternal question when it comes to music recording and production, laptop or desktop? Well, there's definitely some things to think about for both, so let's get right into it. The first thing we should think about is mobility. Am I going to be mobile with a laptop, or do I want the computer to live in a studio permanently in a desktop? This is very important since both have their perks. Mobility is a big thing, especially if you don't have a very nice room and if you work mostly in production or songwriting. Once you have a product that you think is solid or need to record actual instruments, you can go to a nicer studio that does have a good recording and listening setup to properly record or mix any material. This also contributes greatly to production since you can travel around pretty much anywhere with your complete arsenal of tools and ideas everywhere you go. A desktop obviously has no mobility, but there is that sense of familiarity when it comes to workflow, and if you have a nice inviting environment such as this one, you can have people come to you. The only downside of being mobile is the fact that as technology progresses and connections get simpler, us in the professional world require a lot of separate parts to make a mobile setup do what a desktop does easily and effectively under one roof. So, if you're going mobile, get ready to spend some nice chunk of change to get mobile power. Now, let's break down what you need to get a good mobile system. 1, storage. 2, processor and RAM. And 3, connectivity. Let's start with storage. In order to have an excellent performance on a mobile rig, you need to have a dedicated drive just for your operating system and system apps, so no extra software and sound libraries should be installed there. And it is a good practice to leave at least 30% of the drive empty for smooth operation and optimal speed. A good starting point is a 1 TB internal SSD drive. If you use a lot of native apps, you might have to invest in a larger drive. You can save a lot of money by getting the laptop with a basic low-costing drive and swapping it with an aftermarket SSD, which tend to run a little cheaper and offer a lot of more bang for your buck. The only detail here is that you really have to know what you're doing in order to install a fresh native operating system on a new hard drive and replace it with the one installed in your computer. If you're not that hands-on with computer hardware, just purchase a native hard drive with the computer. You should add a second internal SSD drive to host any complementary music apps and sound libraries. Having the drive internally will make operation flawless as there is no downtime in reading external units since they're probably using fast SATA connections, which are normally way quicker than any Thunderbolt or USB speeds. External drives should only be used for file transfer purposes. Do invest in a large capacity 1 TB and up SSD drive in order to cut transfer time when working on different studios than your own mobile rig. That way, you don't have to wait around in order to acquire the files. Now, let's move on to processor and RAM. The centerpiece and most important element of any computing system is the processor. You do not, I repeat, you do not want to be cheap when it comes to choosing your processor. Definitely get the best you can for your budget. The processor is the main driving force of all operations. It can make the entire computing experience faster, quicker, and better. I recommend an Intel 3.5 GHz i7 processor, especially for newer systems. These processors stand the test of time flawlessly. As far as RAM goes, an excellent amount of RAM for any mobile rig is a starting point of 16 GB. This is especially important if you're using native apps and virtual instruments which rely heavily on native processing. Most standard configurations come with 8 GB, so it's always a good idea to upgrade to 16 GB. Again, if you're savvy, you can always buy the least amount of native RAM with a basic configuration and research for some great aftermarket cards. Just make sure to get the same model of all RAM cards and don't mix and match different cards. And again, it doesn't matter if you have a lot of RAM. If the processor is not efficient, it will not harness the true power of the RAM cards. Now, let's move on to connectivity. Newer laptop computer systems are great overall, but when it comes to connectivity, most of them suck. The main reason being that most designs, especially the ones by Apple, have shifted almost exclusively to Thunderbolt connections. If you're buying a system from scratch, this is not a big deal, as you can buy all new Thunderbolt peripherals. But if you're upgrading from an older system that does not incorporate Thunderbolt in the connection flow, and you want to use any of your old peripherals with it, you'll be forced to invest in connectivity interfaces to integrate all parts into the system. The best option, in my opinion, for this is the OWC Thunderbolt 3 dock. This interface expands the capability of minimalist Thunderbolt systems and brings back the professional tools normally found on older systems or desktop configurations, like wired Ethernet ports, an SD card reader, audio I/O, and a variety of USB and FireWire ports, as well as fast Thunderbolt 3 connections to provide even further expansion of peripherals if needed. This will eliminate the need of any extra USB extenders, which are needed to run any DAW properly in a laptop configuration, due to the fact that you need several USB ports just to get iLock and other hardware license keys to authorize the use of any protected software. Not to mention that you need port availability for external hard drives, MIDI keyboards, controllers, etc. Now, let's go back to the desktop. Obviously, these systems are designed to be a complete and powerful turnkey computing solution so that you don't have to spend a lot of time building different parts into a cohesive system. All components live under one roof and it's scalable depending on your configuration. But it usually requires very few extra investments in regards to expansion. These systems do not have the flexibility of being mobile, but they're usually way more robust than any mobile system. They're seen mostly in studios, since they provide a professional experience in regards to connectivity when you're trying to assemble complex I/O grids with several converters and advanced clocking schemes. These normally require an extensive card bay that holds not only graphics cards, which can take two or even three slots in the bay, external DAW processing cards like the Pro Tools HD XL or HDX cards, and expanded storage solutions, which are especially important if you're integrating video into the workflow. Doing this with a laptop would be a peripheral nightmare. So, if you're more of a studio lab rat and are planning to use a lot of different pieces of outboard gear and peripherals, go for a desktop solution. If you plan to do a lot of collabs with different people in different studios and work more inside the box when it comes to mixing and production, then you can get away with a laptop configuration. In the end, try to figure out what really works for you in the long run, since you'll be doing a serious investment towards your rig. I hope this helps you research into investing into your next mobile rig, so do the thing and like this video and subscribe to our channel if you haven't. Visit us on the web at www.musicmastermind.tv and create your free membership and gain access to this and many more incredible videos regarding advanced recording, mixing, and music production practices happening right here inside the professional high-end studio environment. There's a lot of really cool content that you won't see anywhere else. That's it for now, but I'll see you very soon. Alex J, over and out.